First of all, here's a president of the United States, as I pointed out yesterday. Someone emailed me this fact, and I credited the emailer. Far be it for me to steal someone's idea. And I said that here's Barack Obama, who said that Israel, you know, shouldn't be building settlements in Jerusalem, in their capital, because it's, you know, basically offensive to the Palestinians. But building a mosque at Ground Zero, that's okay. That's perfectly okay. A little contradiction there. But what's really lost here is here's a man who has decided, Barack Hussein Obama, that it's okay to build a mosque at Ground Zero. And he wasted no time, you know, weighing in on that. But do we yet know where these bumbling idiots are going to try Khalid Sheikh Mohammed and the four others? This has been going on since last November. Last November, they announced that they were going to try them at Foley Square here in New York City. And then the outrage set in. And then they backed off. And now and then they don't know. And they're deciding. Now, I think they're just waiting till after the election. I'm surprised Obama didn't wait till after the election to weigh in on the mosque. But they're just waiting. After the election, it's all good. Everything's going to come out. Everything's going to come out. This is what we're going to do. We're granting amnesty to the illegals. Here's how we're going to do it. There's going to be no congressional vote. You know, we're going to pass card check in a lame duck session. Everything. We're going to get hit with a ton of the crock of Barack. But why can't they decide on where they're going to try the man who took the towers down? The mastermind. Why is it so difficult to decide that he should be tried in a military tribunal? All right, let's get to a phone call or two or three or whatever. 1-800-321-8828. And let's go to Tony in New Jersey. Hey, Tony, you're on the Steve Malzberg Show.
Hi, Steve. I enjoy your show and I enjoy your passion. I spoke to someone in Governor Christie's office expressing my anger at the fact that he is not taking a position.
Uh-huh.
And then he made that comment about political football. I even called him gutless. I have to admit the man did allow me to speak, so he didn't cut me off or anything. Uh-huh. And he made the usual arguments, the arguments that's being made. Well, you know, it's illegal and this and that. So I said, you know, I'm very disappointed. I said, I voted for Governor Christie because I thought he was a conservative. I said, it seems like he's not a conservative on certain issues. I said, you know, he's governor of New Jersey. There were 9/11 victims from New Jersey. I said, you know.
Well, I just hate to let you. I mean, I believe you, but I hate to let you go on and on about a conversation you had that I can't prove that you had. You know what I'm saying?
I did have the conversation.
No, I know that. I know that. But here's the deal. Governor Christie has done, as Ann Coulter in a previous hour alluded to, has done wonderful, wonderful, brave things in taking on unions and fiscal responsibility. And that's why people have mentioned him as a possible presidential candidate in 2012. Having said that, he's disappointed me in not signing on to the state's court fight against the mandatory purchasing of health care. He promised me that he would tell us about that in March. He didn't. He promised when I had him back on in June, he promised me that he would get, you know, there'd be an announcement the following week. There still has been no announcement. It's now coming up to September. Doesn't look like we're signing on in New Jersey to that lawsuit. And now this. I just don't understand how the governor couldn't just say, you know, what politicians have been saying. You know, what Harry Reid said. You know, they have a right to build it, but it's wrong. Move it. I mean, how could he not say that?
Well, I agree with you. And you know what he said? He said at the end that people have short memories, but if this continues, if the topic doesn't go away, that the governor may change his position. Well, isn't that political?
That's very political. Tony, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Let's go to Kevin in the Bronx, who wants to comment on Steve Forbes. Hey, Kevin.
Oh, hi, Steve. First of all, people were fooled by Christie. He's a rhino. Forbes is interesting with his tax cuts and everything. I love his way he's able to easily announce and talk about tax cuts in the economy, which is great. He should be the Republican national chairman, not this guy Steele, who's just an affirmative
Steele is a joke. No,
yeah.
I was for Steele. I was for Steele, but he became more interested in being a fill-in talk radio host and a TV star than actually doing anything.
Right. I was never fooled by Steele. I knew he was a race quota pick because Obama was the president.
But he wasn't a race quota pick. He ran against many other candidates, and it was a very close vote, and it took several votes. So it was hardly a race quota pick, as you put it. But go ahead. Anything else?
Oh, sure. Well, the thing is, they say, you know, a lot of things is going Obama's way. If you look at it, he had this health care thing. He's lacing the federal government with judges he's appointing. He's got two picks on the Supreme Court. The borders are wide open. They're flooding the country with illegal aliens. Republicans aren't doing. We've lost over 8 million jobs. They don't even talk about ending legal immigration. No one talks about that.
You're not Steve, are you, from Manhattan?
No.
Okay. No, you're right. You're right, though, Kevin. You're right. Sound a little bit like Steve. Maybe you're related to Steve. It all comes back to immigration for Steve, and you sound like him. But whether you are or not, yeah, we are talking about illegal immigration. And I fear what they're going to do, him and Janet Napolitano, you know, Janet Napolitano, they're going to circumvent the Congress and they're going to grant amnesty to the illegals. You wait and you see. Let's go to Morty in Brooklyn. Hello, Morty. Morty, going on. No, that's not Morty. Hello, Morty.
How you doing, Steve? Long time no speak.
Yeah, where have you been, Morty?
I listen to you every
Friday.
Day.
You got better things to do than call?
Right now, we listen to Malzberg every single day.
All right, I'm kidding. Go ahead, Morty.
There was a report today, I believe, by Politico that they released a photocopy of Obama's...
passport. It's
the passport.
Passport.
Now, is there any truth or is this just another gimmick?
Well, Politico put it out. Josh Gerstein put it out. And it says, here's something for the new for the birthers to chew over. President Barack Obama's passport says he was born in Hawaii, but the White House has strategically fuzzed out certain data, so the mystery continues. It says now it is his official passport, which means it's new, so true believers will not be persuaded, not that they ever would. They blurred out the issuance date, they blurred out the expiration date, and they blurred out other information. So why would you have to blur out, if you're the White House, anything on Obama's passport if you're releasing it? What's so secretive on the passport? And I'm talking about our next guest, Nat Hentoff, ladies and gentlemen, the great Nat Hentoff. Hey, Nat, how are you?
Furious, because all of this fury nationally and internationally about the First Amendment right to exercise free exercise of religion, all of this has nothing whatever to do with that. We've had mosques in this city for years. In fact, a few years ago, this imam, who's at the center of this, Faisal Abdul Rauf, was the lead in prayer at a mosque 12 blocks for where he wants to put this mosque at Ground Zero. No, this has nothing to do with, nobody disagrees with the right to freedom of expression, or if they do, they don't know the Constitution. This has to do with two things. One is, of course, why specifically this location was picked, and who is, all the newspapers except a few, call him the very epitome of the moderate Islamist. He is quite opposite to that.
Well, yeah.
And the thing is, this should have tipped it, but it only got very little attention except in the New York Post. The co-founder of Hamas has come out delighted with the idea of having the mosque, and he says, we have to build everywhere.